So a few changes down there on court for both teams. And remember, day three, Argentina coming off a relatively short break between both matches. It'll just take a little time for this match to settle down and for both teams to find their rhythm. Coach for Argentina, born in Buenos Aires, but has done the rounds on the pro circuit, had a very successful coaching career in Brazil with Santa Cruzada. Andrea Gianni, 474 international caps for Italy, only ever played in Italy, but now on his second international job after Slovenia, outside of his home nation. We're ready to go then. Best of five sets. Argentina in the white, Germany in their black strip. And it'll be Argentina to serve to get this one underway. And the stability of the pass continues. Beautiful ball into Zimmermann. And Christian Fromm, with his second hit here in Cannes, puts that one away with power. Beautiful kill from the German captain. The blocker, Buxpoller. On court for the tallest man in the German team at 2 meters and 11. That's another cracking kill on the overpass. Yeah, Gunther not starting. Good serve from Buxpoller. You can't really do that. You can't give the ball back to a man who's 2 meters and 4 at the net. Not a man built like Fromm. He's going to melt it. Good shot. Slightly tired start from Argentina, but Palacios and Kreer, two fresh sets of legs out on court. It's Palacios that gets the kill. He did feature yesterday, played quite a vital role, actually, in the set that France dominated, set they won. Marcelo Mendes just threw him in there to give Conte a break. Well, I said we'd see a sketchy start to this match. Germany have started well. Argentina scrubbing around for points at the moment. Malecha to serve, the opposite spiker. Nice work, Argentina's tallest man, Pablo Kreer, with the kill. Dzeko will try and feed him quite a bit today. Yeah, lovely look. That's a hell of a set. He's a long way away from his middleman there, and he's found him brilliantly. Bremer, the teenager, beaten. But Bremer will come back with a bit of his own firepower now. I wouldn't be surprised to see Zimmermann going middle to Bremer here, so this might be the first test for Kreer. No, can't set middle off that pass. Can only set his captain, gets the job done out of system. Well, we call that a wing spiker's pass because basically the only person you can set is the wing spiker. Fromm almost guaranteeing himself the ball there. Not deliberately, of course. Decent serve from Argentina, but an out of system kill is always valuable. And that sends the German captain back to the baseline. Nope, no timing about that serve. Bremer's got his first kill of the game, courtesy of a wipe-off hit. Couple of slowdown blocks in there as well for the teenager. And finishes off of Pablo Kreer's hands, so really good run of play there from the number 12. Looks like Germany have found an excellent middle player in 19-year-old Anton Bremer. Now, can Fromm hit a decent serve? He can. That's more like it. Well, I told you Dzeko's going to try and find Kreer as many times as he can. One thing that Kreer really can do is side the ball out. What a light frame, but a very tall man, and that power-to-weight ratio gets him into the air fast. Gets good hang time. And a nice target for Dzeko to find. Palacios then, the wing spiker who's on for Facundo Conte at the start of this game. Shot going for the hands, but missing them, and missing the court. Quite clearly clear of the hands there, so no challenge forthcoming. Now let's have a look at Argentina's service targets here. I would imagine they're going to go as hard as they can at from. Bounces over and goes to shot instead. And Malesha's first attempt to kill the ball is unsuccessful. Decent set from Zimmerman. Well, Germany going to challenge. Be interesting to see what for, because I didn't see that hit anything except the advertising hoardings. But we'll have a go at this. It could be a net touch challenge. They think Argentina maybe just transgressed. Because it didn't look like it was... No, referee says no. He's seen the... Well, we are going to go for it. Yeah, Stefano Cesari just finally clarifying with Argentina what this is all about. It's whether there's a net touch, and there wasn't. So no fault, Argentina keep the point. And we go on with the scores level. So an early dabble on the challenge from Gianni, not successful. Germany lose that challenge. They got one left for this set. Yeah, Fromm is the target, and he's struggling at the moment on pass. So we're going to see a few out-of-system kills here from Germany. And by that, by out-of-system, we mean when the ball is not under control and you're not playing exactly the attack you wanted to play. So shot from Malesha. A lot of work to do today, I think, if Argentina keeps serving as hard as they are on from. Bremer. Good pick up from Bremer. Nice. Really good swing from Palacios. It was a super spike indeed. Two attempts to kill the ball by Germany, unsuccessful. Fromm's not timing it at the moment. Then Palacios makes the defence and then runs the pipe attack. See how quickly the wing spikers have to recover and move to the net. Look at that from net cap. Awesome, including Denani's celebration. Love it. 6-6. Yeah, that's going to go to Argentina. If the setter is front court, then they get up there and challenge on the joust and try and set. But if they are back court, referees tend to go with the blocker. Yeah, that's what Stefano Cesari is explaining, that the set was happening over the net. Yeah, that's German, and that's Argentina's ball to play. It's being played. So a good shout for the ref, despite Zimmerman looking a little confused. No, Fromm's missed that one. Well, he's a little bit out of form. He's had some injury issues this year, Christian Fromm. It's great to see him back on court, but at the moment, just taking a bit of time to really get firing.
The receivers are perfect. Only this, eh? This is perfect. We play
better. First technical timeout arrives. After a good start from the German team, Argentina have come back. Christian Fromm, the captain, been rested up until this point. He's on. Clubbed the first ball. I mean, that was a really encouraging sign. Then he clubbed the overpass. So you're thinking, Fromm's back in business here. Two fantastic kills. But he struggled a bit on service reception, and he's had a mistimed serve and a mistimed attack. All the good that he's done has partially been undone, but he's going to need a bit of time to warm up here. So three kills, but he's also probably cost his team 3 points as well. So in terms of his account in this match, he's on 0 at the moment. Not into the red yet. Little blocker, Pablo Cré. Touch from him, but spirals away from Lima. Lesche gets his first kill on the board, so that'll settle the opposite player down for Germany. Yeah, Dzeko, after he set Palacios that first pipe, it would have been in the back of his mind that the next time the option comes, go again. And he's completely sucked Buxpoller into that, although Buxpoller, the middle blocker for Germany, does tend to overcommit a little in the middle. Oh, wow. But who cares when you can hit the ball that well? Lovely set from Zimmermann. Very quick tempo to this one. This is just out of the setter's hands as he whacks this. Oh, great stuff. Good enough for a bit of 99 red balloons from Nana. Served well so far this week. Nice, very nice. Well, it's not all about power from the service line. And this is what the jump servers realised early on. If you fake the jump serve and just roll it, sure, really does catch the passers out. And on this occasion, Poglajan very flat-footed. 9-all. 9-9-zik, funnily enough. Gets it wrong on the second serve when he tries to introduce the power back in. So we've still got a situation here where both teams are just trying to find some sort of rhythm. Fromm still the target, better pass, and a nice kill. Dzeko will be annoyed that he hasn't made this play, but that's a decent hit from the German captain, Christian Fromm. It's going to be an interesting contest, that one. Argentina against Fromm with the serve. Wow, that's a crazy set. No, and that one isn't so good. And unfortunately for Dzeko, he didn't quite read the fact that Augustin Lusser had not got off the net and approached again. Look at that, he's in exactly the same place. That's virtually a standing start. The middle player. Maybe the pipe to Poglajan would have been the better option, but always easy with hindsight. Buxpoller to serve. Nice pass. No, good dig from Germany. And a great tomahawk play from Zimmermann. Dzeko is just determined to open this middle channel. There's the tomahawk from Zimmermann. But an easy ball back and an easy kill from Lusser straight through the arms of Bremer. Great touch, well played by Schott. Fromm rolls it off pace and gets blocked by Lima. Needed a touch more respect for the Argentinian block there. Good recycle from Germany. Fromm just rolls it into the block and gets played back past him by Lima. It was a monsterish block. Get there. Talent on the Argentinian bench waiting to come on. Might see Conte at some point, but Argentina doing a good enough job at the moment. Good swing from Bremer again. Terrific 15 points on day one, followed up with 10 yesterday. He he's been the pick of the German players so far this week in terms of his offensive capability. Still only 19, doesn't play like that, plays with real maturity. There we go, Piper Tack again, it's coming back. Bump set from Danani, Lima misses. Might see a challenge, but I've got an idea there that Dzeko was wagging his finger at the bench to maybe discourage his coach Mendes from pressing the challenge button. They are going to have a little go here. They are going to ask the question, and it will not be a positive response. Sometimes you can just see it with the naked eye. In fact, it's Germany that challenged, so that means the referee gave this to Argentina. So this will be Germany's point. Hawkeye, tell us what happened. No touch. Fantastic, isn't it? This introduction of technology into volleyball over the last few years has given us a whole new dimension to the game. It's not just the fact that the challenge system exists to sort out decisions that you disagree with, but you also get another view on the game. Just see the height and the athleticism of the players above the net. No need to challenge that one, it was out. Lima's been quiet so far, just a single point to his name, but 18 yesterday in that marvellous victory against France, and he's got an ace to make it two. He leans back a little bit when he hits this, he's got the ball just a touch behind his shoulder. Just gives you that little bit of extra whip on the topspin to really bring it down towards the line. He goes for it again. Nice pass from Schott. And slow down block. Chance for a point again for Argentina. Garcios can't put it away. Christian Fromm, on the other hand, no problem. Nice running set from Zimmermann. Yeah, that's really well controlled by the German setter and nicely put away by the skipper. He's a big lad, Fromm. Now, back to the service line. First serve he hit was all over the shop. Second serve, though, was really heavy topspin. He's got a fantastic serve, capable of runs of aces. It's not quite working, is it, at the moment for the German captain? Just having a word there from with Brehm to warn him that the Argentinians are picking on Fromm in the back line, and if he's not careful, he'll get hit with the serve. They've missed Fromm. Too easy on the pass for Zenger. Well, somehow Argentina are putting the ball away. And they are just wandering around in transition. Honest, look at that from Dzeko. Nobody knew what they were supposed to do next. Luckily, Danani was there to sort it out. Nice wide bump set to Podlein. Contact point from him. Argentina lead at the second technical timeout.
Vamos a seguir agresivo con el saque en los puntas que los complicamos mucho, tanto con el flotado, tanto con el saltado. No nos pasemos los ataques por cuatro bloqueos.
Ezequiel Palacios on court for Facundo Conte.
Vamos, señor.
I'm doing a good job. Bit of a bruiser as wing spikers go, but he gets the job done nicely. But what you must always remember about the players on the left side of court is there is an extra dimension to the game. It's not just about thumping the ball. It's about the ability to pass the services of the opposition, and he's doing a solid job so far. 3 points to his name. He'd like to add an ace here, just like Lima did when he came to the service line a couple of rotations ago. Well, it's not an ace, but an overpass, good enough. Very casual put away, wasn't it, from Poglain? Doesn't whack it, just tries to roll it into space, and Zenger can't control it. Terrific commitment again from the players. They do a lot of this in training, chasing the ball, chasing lost causes. And the substitution has happened because from once again on service reception, just not able to control the ball. So Reichert in, he and Schott have been passing well this week. So Christian Fromm lost his place on court already. That's an ace. Whoa, that looked close. That looked close. We might see a challenge from Argentina. I think referee may have given this one in. Remember, if the ball compresses and touches the line, it's all counts. But no, it has gone Germany's way, and Argentina don't want a challenge. Keeping their powder dry. Nice work. Well, Lima was impressive. He's not the starting opposite. That slot belongs to the much more experienced Pereira. But Pereira picked up a head injury on day one. He was okay to carry on in the match, but watched him warm up today, and he wasn't completely committed to the warm-up. So no surprise to see Lima getting another start, but we may see the double substitution and Pereira involved later. Cheeky tip from Schott. Wow, Losa jumped and appeared behind his own skipper there and played the ball. If he left it, Lima would have picked it up easily, as Lima is just explaining to the young middle blocker. Touch off the block is the only way Argentina will get the point. Loza completely convinced. Dzeko heard the sound as well. And Argentina this time will go to the challenge. And the question that is going to be asked is, did this touch the block or not? It's one of those challenges where I think all the players down on the floor know what the answer is. Yeah, it's pinged the index finger on the left hand of Bugs Poile. Two meters and 10 tall, Bugs Poile. Gets a long way above the net. But can be a target sometimes. Dzeko serves. Good lineup for the next three rotations in front court for Argentina. Malesha with an untidy spike wide of the court. Good pass again. Zenger's passing like a dream this week. Timeout Germany. And the wheels coming off a bit here in set one for the German side. Well, it didn't last long, did it, for Christian Fromm? He was on, then he was off. And the problem that Fromm has is, as far as Andrea Gianni is concerned, he can't score enough points at the net to cover the amount of points he's going to lose the German team if Argentina keeps serving him as well as they were. That's not to say he won't feature again in the game, but at the moment Reichert is on, a player that's just passed. And Malesha stuffed. It's a feature of volleyball at this level that the blockers read so well what's happening on the other side of the net. When the hitter's isolated, they'll get three blockers there to shut everything down. That's really good work from Lima and Loza. Poglain just shutting down the cross court to force the hitter into the block. Wide. Checo's just hit Gianni. By the way, the German coach didn't even flinch. There we go. Oh, nearly skills. Back to shot at the service line. One good ace with that off-pace serve, but missed the one that he went for with power. That's a better hit. Argentina just have to shovel it over. Good work. Very nice hit from shot. And once again, the setter Zimmermann choosing to go to shot because he's just hit a jump serve. So make him hit something similar again from the back line. It's a repetition of the skill. It's a good setting choice. Oh, wow, it's up. Unbelievable. That is sensational. What a recovery from Germany. And it's all to no avail. Well, what a shame. That is pickup of the week. Very delicately played as well. And Lima just puts it away. Christian Fromm back on court in the front line. Look at that from shot. That's just wonderful. Germany forced into a timeout despite the circus skills. Argentina still put it away. Second timeout then for Gianni, used.
Okay, guys, now, yeah.
So no further options for Gianni to stop the match unless it's with a challenge or a substitution. And Argentina are not firing on all cylinders, I can tell you. This is a very workmanlike performance from the team. After yesterday's fabulous win against France, just trying to keep things going for back-to-back victories, which will be four on the VNL this year. Germany, on the other hand, trying to recover from losing four on the bounce, and shots like that will not help Malaysia into the net. Can't quite believe he's done this. Good block to set it up. That should have been a free kill. But Malaysia off balance, didn't jump high enough. Nearly pulled the net down. Good serve, overpass, is away. And that will be a little warning for Bucks Poller. You're not allowed to grab hold of the net and pull it in anger. When you're frustrated, sometimes it's just the nearest thing to hand, and referee, the manager, that is just having a word. The big middle blocker for Germany. Six set points then for Argentina for a 1-0 lead. Five opportunities to attack for the same result. I think Marcelo Mendes will be really pleased with the way his team have played here. Two new players on court. It's made very little difference to their performance level. A dig, a quick. He's a cheeky boy, is the Checo. He's lovely to watch. Got all sorts of tricks in the bag. First set from him was a bump to the middle player. You don't see that often. 25-19 then. Argentina continue where they left off last night against France, and they're not really firing at the moment. That'll be the worry for Germany, who are playing with a complete lack of confidence right now. Let's have a look at this. That's brilliant. And it was nearly successful. In the end, Lima having to apply the finishing touch. Doing so very nicely indeed. 5 points for him. Joint top scorer with Palacios on the Argentinian side of the net. And, Germany have some thinking to do here because Argentina have taken control of this game already. So good, positive, and I have to say, relaxed start from Argentina. So even when they were under pressure, even things were a little out of system, they just played with a smile on their face and got the job done very nicely indeed. So comfortable stats, comfortable win in set one. Argentina having fun and getting the job done. Behind every victory in a set, there's always a story. That's what Hawkeye is very often able to give us, that little bit of information behind the scenes, as it were. Argentinian serve placement, I can promise you, just about every single one of those serves in the first set, until Christian Fromm was removed from the court, was aimed at the big number one, the German captain. So they followed him across the back line. Germany's point of view, well, I'm not really sure that there's too much of a plan there. Serving into one, so putting a little bit of pressure on the backcourt wing spiker. The other half of the serves going to the other wing spiker, generally the front court player, but it's not providing them with any help at all. And that single ace, not enough pressure from the service line for Argentina. Argentina coping comfortably with that German service pattern. So where we go then, set two, it is a race to three, so Germany with a chance to try and come back into this. Just looking down on the floor, Christian Fromm is still out there, so the German captain will start set two. Zimmermann setting, shot the other wing spiker. Malesha opposite, Bremer and Buxpola through the middle. Down on the court for Argentina, well, no need to change things at the moment, it's all working just fine. So DiCecco setting, Lima, thoroughly impressive, in the number 12 shirt opposite. Max Poller will serve to get set two underway. Then we've got Palacios and Poglayan in the wing spiker position. Danani in the libero slot with Losa and Kreer through the middle. So no changes on either side of the net from set one. And a nice start from Palacios. Decent kill. Good opener for Argentina. Takes them back to the service line. Well, they've been causing real problems for the big number one. Christian Fromm just practicing his pass at the top of the shot. No, they don't hit him. But he hits them. Well defended, but it's a free ball. And Argentina get it into transition again. Oh my goodness, just one set too many in the middle. Bremer was waiting for it. And the teenager's got himself a big block. Monster block here. From it was with the big hit that kind of got Argentina unsettled. And then Bremer on the Kreer. Lovely shutdown. Good read from the youngster. Well, it happens. We saw Brizard France put one a little higher up into the stands yesterday from the service line. These guys are hitting the ball very hard, but if you don't get your hand over the top of the ball on the jump serves, it won't go down. That went down, but not to the floor. Argentina recycle again. Germany having to work hard for their points here. Bremer remains impressive. Bremer currently with a pro contract to Berlin, ECO Berlin Volleys. I would imagine there are a few coaches around Europe considering Bremer as an option. He's looked really impressive here in Cannes. Good serve from Fromm, trying to play himself into the game. Terrific from Germany. Oh, DiCecco. In he comes to sort it out. It was dismissive. So good hit from Lima. Comes back, gets popped over the net. DiCecco, look at that, had a look at the middle player. He actually had a look at Kreer just to see if the set was on. It wasn't, so he hit it. Got so much time in the game. It's amazing. Heavy serve from Palacios, well past Germany. Oh, lovely defence from Malesha, but Zenger just can't quite hook it back into play. Well, the problem for Germany remains. Their service reception is absolutely on the money. It's to the setter Zimmermann so many times, but they just can't put the ball away on a consistent basis. Palacios again. He's got it wrong this time. Great shot of the spin that the players put on the ball for the jump serve. So they actually impart top spin. They roll the fingers up the back of the ball as they throw it. That sends the ball spinning forwards, and then they cap it for extra topspin. Nearly worked. Decent enough pass, though, from Argentina. Pablo Correa once again finds the core. And the reason that De Checo is so determined to set that middle channel, he wants to pin the blockers. He wants to keep Bugs Poller jumping with the wrong man. Give his wing spikers just one player to hit past in the block. And Zimmermann, as is so often the case, is tit for tat. Rijkaard having a word with his coach Gianni, so we might see Rijkaard on at some point. Lovely set, lovely spike, Bugs Poller, 2 metres and 10 tall, spiking it at 3.20. Good serve, Zimmermann. Out of system, Argentina, all three blockers on it for Germany, and they are going to win the point. Now, did that come back inside the antenna? If it did, then that's sensational. Look at that effort from Zimmermann, and he spun it back over the net between the two antenna, and De Checo this time is stopped. Wonderful commitment from the German setter. Five all. Not this time. With an excellent dive for a big man. It's good mobility. As this ball pings off of Bugs Poller's fingers. Checo waits. Good three rotations to come for Argentina. This is where they pulled away in set one. Yeah, too good. It's come off the foot, so it was still in play, but it's disappeared. And De Checo, the free net maestro, earns his team another one. Look at this, no blockers. Have a go, fill your boots. Sios more than happy to oblige, but watch this come square off the foot of Fromm. Oh, knee, in fact. Thought it had come off his shoe, but it's his knee pad. Rijkaard in for Malesha. That's interesting. And that is why Coach Gianni was just having a long conversation with his wing spiker, because he was explaining that you're coming on out of position. But bizarrely, the first hit he gets is in position. That's his left side of court play. But now he's going to go across and block on the right side in place of Malesha. Oh, brilliant movement from Bugs Poller. Went with the wrong player to start with, but a really good recovery. This time, doesn't fully commit on the middle. Just a little 50%er, and that allowed him to get off the floor and go again, and Fromm helping him out with a big paw coming across to join the block, and Gianni happy enough. Well, he's got another option, has Gianni, for the next set. He can bring Rijkaard back to his normal side of court with shot and switch Fromm into the opposite position, take him out of the pass. And that's what he's done. So Fromm staying on the right side of court at the moment. Rijkaard on the left, even though he's replaced Malesha. Good hustle from Germany. But it's a free ball, Argentina. Here we go. No. Always fantastic for a team when they work that hard to get the ball back in play to then win the point. Terrific touch from Zenger. That's a zinger from Zenger, and shot slides into the hoardings to make the play again. The hitting error from Losa, giving Germany the point. And Andrea Gianni has pulled off a little coaching masterstroke here. It is true to say, it is always about you, it's always about the team and how you play, but you have to adjust to what's going on the other side of the net. Here we go. Here's the player of the day, player of the week, let's be honest. Look at this. You see it once in a blue moon. I think it was the Korean libero went viral a few years ago, chasing off into the dressing rooms to make his play with his foot. And that ain't far off it. Great effort from Schott, but just didn't bring a point for Germany. And there he is, there's the man of the moment. Bit of pressure on Argentina here. Very different lineup in the front court. Now let's see if Rijkaard goes right side or Fromm goes right side. That'll tell us what's happening. It is Fromm. So Gianni's going to put Fromm in the opposite position, I think, next set. Good hustle again. Popped over by Rijkaard. Now this time they get it right. Really decent swing. Argentina very confident. Super shot from another new player on court. So Martin Ramos. Now this is weird. Ramos normally is an opposite spiker. But Lima's the opposite. Well, both coaches here doing something a little bit out of the box, because Ramos is in the middle. Number 18 shirt. That is not his familiar position, which is why he got absolutely nowhere near Backspola on that one. It's unusual. So still no place for Solé on the court for Argentina. I can't imagine an opposite spiker saying to his coach, "Do you know what, coach, I could really do with a run out in the middle." Because it is a run out, it's a tough position. That's what's happened so far, and there he is, Ramos, new on court. Easy pass for Zenger. And a decent kill from Schott. Three blockers, semi-read it. Just couldn't put up anything decent to stop it, Lima. There we go, there's the referee's signal for touch. Rijkaard. So that's the one point at which Fromm will have to go to the left side in that rotation, because Zimmermann's in the front court with him, so the setter has to be right side. Watch Fromm move here. His hands above his head. There he goes. Serves missed, but that's the one rotation Fromm still has to play there. I think that'll be changed for the next set. Fromm will go to the opposite. Captain gets the set, has to tip it onto the floor. Ceremoniously killed by the German captain. Not pretty, but effective. Up goes the big claw. To the service line now, so new left side player shot in the front court. There he is in the number three shirt. Well, Argentina out of system for virtually the whole game today. They've done very little right on the money, and they're still in there and competing. Beautiful hit from Palacios, 102.6 kilometers per hour. So it was a controlled hit, controlled power. It's over, just. Whoa. Christian Fromm will be starting in the opposite position in the next set. I'm absolutely sure of it after this hit. That's a crunching blow from the back line. Well, Germany may have found a change-up that will work for them next week and save them having a battle in that relegation zone. Bremer misses the serve. No challenge at the moment forthcoming from Germany. Straight over to Gianni, wants to show him a few things on the clipboard, just a reminder of Argentina's attacking patterns. No, free ball. Goodness me, both teams messing it up. And again. Can someone get control of it? Right, Argentina for the point. Can't do it. Germany's still hanging in there. Shot. That's a super kill. Horrible rally, but it's ended up finally with a decent shot to kill it. 5.1 seconds. You've always got to spare a thought for the middlemen during the longer rallies because they have to jump in the block, get off the net, and then jump in attack every time. So multiple passes of the ball over the net is a middle player's nightmare. Zimmermann to serve. Three good rotations for Germany. They've got Reichert and Schott in the front court at the moment. So this is the one rotation where Reichert has to play right side before Fromm joins him. So it's a mix and match rotation at the moment for Germany. That will be sorted out in the next one. Good dipping topspin. Speculative from the German bench and wrong. It was in. Good kill. Reichert's one hit through the left side and he'll switch to the right. So two opportunities to hit on that side of court so far. He's put both of them away quite comfortably. Shot back to the service line, and really interesting set this one. All sorts going on down there on the floor in terms of substitutions and rotations. It's going to be tight. Yeah, that's good. Oh, wow. Well, I think I'm with Dzeko there. The setters union will be having words about this. That was under control, and that got touched by Buxpoller. But backcourt setter, referee saying no, can't play it in German airspace. And the referee's decision, as we know, is final. Unless it's challenged. But you can't challenge that one. Good dig. No. And Stefano Cesari repairs the situation by giving that one to Argentina. It's Germany's chance to shout. Double touch. See what you think. Well, slipped a bit, didn't it, through the fingers. Enough for the referee to say two touches on Zimmermann. Poglian to serve Argentina level. Good hit. Overpass. There we go. 15-0. Zenger's not done much wrong this week, but this was just a little too heavy for him. And in Zenger's defence, he's partially covering Fromm on that zone on court. That one came to him really square, and I just don't think he was ready for it. I think he was expecting it to be on to his captain's side. No, dear me. It's not come down yet. So Germany have the lead at the second technical timeout, and certainly playing a lot better with this particular group of players in the rotation.
Peguémosle la bola, está el bloqueo doble acá, sí, busquemos una mano de afuera y le damos la bola. No dejemos caer más la bola en el medio, no ataquemos más para el medio de la cancha, busquemos la mano y le tiramos arriba la mano. Aceleremos el último paso de ataque. Sí, entrar un poco más separado para poder atacar el primer tiempo también. ¿Estamos? Tenemos que mejorar eso nada más, señores, porque el bloqueo se la estamos tocando toda. ¡Vamos! ¡Vamos! ¡Vamos!
Ahí, ahí, eso, eso, eso. It's all relative, but at 1.98 m. Lima in the opposite spiker position. He isn't quite tall enough, but he makes up for that with a huge jump. He's such a clean hitter. Really does put the ball away beautifully. He's got a powerful arm. And he's up against the likes of Schott and Reichert, who are a little bit shorter than him. His block is effective as well. Had a good game so far. Argentina holding it together. Not their top scorer on 7. That belongs to Palacios. He's had 4 attacks, 2 blocks, and an ace serve, Lima. So, multiple skills from the opposite. Oh, that's a good shot. Palacios didn't really get much time to approach there. But was forced to do so by a super quick set from Dzeko as well. That's a lovely set, lovely hit. Zimmermann, lucky again. He missed it, he has, and I think he knows it as well. Reichert hangs his head as he wanders over. It's not a super spike because it's out, but it was a nice hit. No challenge from Germany because Reichert knew it was a miss, so Andre Gianni signals for a timeout.
Especially when the receiver's a perfect, when free ball, with that maximum power, eh? Maximum. I want to broken the ball. It's the same for the receiver. You serve, eh? The ball stays 3 meters.
I love it. He wants him to break the ball. He wants him to hit it so hard it's going to break. So free ball, he wants serious power. As Andrea Gianni. From the service line, he wants the same. He wants Dzeko forced to the 3 meter line so that he can't keep opening up the middle part of the court with the A-quicks to the middles and with the pipe attacks, which have been working well. From off pace. That'll do. Remember, Christian Fromm, I think he's going to be switched to the opposite. At the moment, Reichert is on for Malesha in the opposite position, so it's a bit of messy in this German rotation. They're having to do a bit of everything, the wing spikers. But I think we'll see Fromm changed out wide on the right side of court. And I think Reicher, who's just about to serve, will be back in his wing spiker role with shot in set 3, whatever the result here. Easy pass, well done from Danami. And there it is. As soon as Dzeko is in front of the 3 meter line, he's in the green zone. That's where the setter wants the ball, and he can cause all sorts of problems for this German block, even when they read where it's going. Bremer saw what was happening, just couldn't stop it. Lima gets it wrong from the service line. Just threw the ball up and it threw it across his body, so it went towards his left arm rather than his right arm and ended up chasing it to the line. 18-all. Crunch time now. This is going to be a good contest to win this one. Can Fromm get his team a couple of aces? Serve, well passed again, right in the green zone. And it just allows Dzeko to run the show under complete control. Maximum deception. And what he does that little look at the middle player to suggest to Bremer that that's where he's going to set. Bremer just getting overloaded as Puckspoiler is. Now, the Argentinian double substitution. First time we've seen this. Palacios is at the service line. use this substitution in the first set, but they were quite a long way ahead, so just trying to flip the rotation around. Uriarte in. Number five, the new setter on court for Argentina. Argentina at the moment not putting any serves in court. It's not helping. Wow. I did not think we would see Simon Hirsch during the course of this week. Had a scan on his ankle on day one, which revealed no break, but that could still be ligament damage. He still seemed to be hobbling around a bit yesterday. And he's been brought on here for his serve. Well, he's still protecting that ankle. As he landed on the one leg, and he was didn't look happy at all there. Well, that's a bizarre decision. Can't quite get my head around that one. Certainly hasn't been successful. Pablo Creer means three service errors in a row for Argentina, and if they lose this set, they can look back to this particular phase of play. This is poor discipline from the South Americans. Given Germany a golden opportunity here, can somebody step up to the plate? Had to be a float serve because it had to be in, and it's worked. So Zimmermann's hand forced there because of the previous service errors from both Argentina and Germany. He had to put the ball in court with a float serve, and it's a cracker. Totally caught Pogliano out. And it's Marcelo Mendes' turn to call a timeout, put a stop to the play. Well, coaches make substitutions to make their team stronger in various phases of the match, but they don't always work. And this one hasn't worked. I have to say, the double sub, Duriati coming on. And the other opposite that started the week but hasn't played much since. He's now on court. Pereira in the number two shirt. And now Mendes is on. Wing spiker, number 17 shirt to shore up the pass. So, really new group of players on court for Argentina here. Is it going to work? Uriarte goes to Pereira, who hammers it. Good to see him back on the playing surface after falling over on day one and cracking his head. That is some jump. Reds it down the line past shot. At last, a serve in for the Argentinian team. And they can't bring it back into play. Another good run from the back line for captain Christian Fromm. That smile from Andrea Diani is a smile to himself, because he's changed this up really nicely for the German team. And he might just have found himself a combination of players when he puts them in the right rotation, that is, that will work in set three. And they might be going there at one all. Pressure on Argentina, shot to serve, off pace. Doesn't work for the ace this time, but it's caused a disruption for Argentina. And a poor set for once from Dzeko, forcing Pogliano away from the net, couldn't use the line. Took on Buxpola unsuccessfully. Monster block from Buxpola, reaching over. Down it goes. So a two-point cushion opened up for Germany. Argentina, once again, their hand forced, changing back to their original lineup. So in fact, it wasn't Dzeko with the set then, was it? It was Uriarte. My apologies to the great man. He's back on court though now, and it's not had an effect. Two roof blocks from Buxpola. Monster blocking from the German middle. And Andrea Diani knows he's got a lineup out there on court that can win this match now. They've got to start by winning this set, but they're in good shape. Now we're going to see a challenge, are we? Argentina to ask if there was a net touch in here, I suspect. Did Buxpoller touch the net before the ball hit the floor? When the ball's hit the floor, it's dead. You can do what you want after that, within reason, and you won't lose the point. This is more of a time delay tactic from Charles Mendes. Yeah, certainly the Argentinian players have kind of stood in their serve reception zones at the moment. I think they're ready to go again. So, officials trying to find an angle that will show whether the ball's hit the floor before Buxpoller has hit the net, if he did hit the net. Very cool. Sums up the drama, doesn't it, the soundtrack? Crowd getting a little fractious as we wait for this one. But it's quite a big call. If it is in Germany's favour, then they have three set points. If it's in Argentina's favour, we're on a very different dimension with regard to this set. Now, Buxpoller touches the net, and down it goes. Whoa, it must have been the ball into the net that forced it into his arms. So Buxpoller's okay there on that one. Definitely was a net touch, but if it's the net's forced into your arms, then there we go. And yeah, Marcelo Mendes not convinced about that one. So timeout Argentina to try and salvage the situation in set two.
No tienen ataque, atacan en el medio, atacan adelante, nada más. Por atrás no ataca. Tenemos que estar conscientes de eso, bloquear, ¿sí? Bloquear para adelante. Pero principalmente nuestro ataque, señores, ¿eh? Nuestro ataque tenemos que buscarle la mano, tenemos que buscarle las manos y rotar. Sí, estamos con muy baja la rotación. Tenemos que acelerar nosotros y rotar. Estamos pensando en eso nada más.
Marcelo Mendes spent 10 years at the Brazilian club Sada Cruzeiro. Three FIVB World Club Championship titles, five South American Championship titles, five Super League titles in Brazil before moving on to pastures new. So he's a quality coach, we know that. And he's engineered a great result yesterday against France. But I think today's a tougher job, you know. No problem getting the players fired up for yesterday's match. This is a very different demand. Some tired bodies. Two set points still to Argentina. Poglain gets it over, but Germany can win this one. Sorry, I said to Argentina, it's Germany that can win the set. Well, chance here for Argentina to save another one. They do, off the fingers from Lima. And now the pressure comes for Germany. And they go from feeling comfortable that there were two chances to win it to feeling distinctly nervous about this next jump serve from Poglain. Doesn't go to Fromm, goes to Zenger. Fromm can win it. He does. Brilliant hit from the German captain. And I think that's a poor bit of game management. Poglain trying to swing as hard as he could and hitting Zenger when he had the opportunity to try and force the issue with a serve on to Christian Fromm. But Fromm gets his team out of trouble. We'll have to see where he starts the next set, Christian Fromm. I suspect it'll be in the opposite position in replacement of Malesha. Nice pass, really solid kill. Germany not only have levelled the match, but Andrea Gianni, their coach, may have just found a combination of players out there on the floor that can make it back-to-back victories in the VNL over Argentina over these two seasons. I think there's a long way to go in this one. Well played, Germany. 25-23. Germany level the score. Thank you. Some fairly serious changes in that set for Germany, but it clicked, didn't it? Started to look much, much better. Five blocks from Germany on the Argentinian attackers. Just shows they're starting to read the patterns of play. Dzeko not quite able to weave the kind of magic that he did yesterday against France. For Argentina, some serious concerns. No kill blocks, no ace serves. And they're going to have to address that matter as this game moves on. But Germany are definitely going to put some different players out on the floor in different positions, I think. Well, one of the key reasons that a team can run a decent offense is how many times you get that ball into the green zone for your setter to just help you side it out. 60% is okay, but that means a lot of out-of-system attacking. Instead, we get that as long as the focus was on serving from. Then, in set two, it's all changed. So Rijkaard, Schott and Zenger are now passing the ball more often than not instead of from. And look at that. Up it goes to 83%. That's where Germany have been all week. And that allows Zimmermann to run some really good offense. And that's why Argentina, at the moment, can't block the ball. One all. We'll have a little look down on the floor to see where everybody is. Schott is out there. Rijkaard is out there. We need to see where Zimmermann is going to start to see if Fromm is on the opposite rather than one of the wing spikers still. Or is Gianni going to say, look, that rather weird and wonderful lineup that we had to work our way through is good enough. There we go. Wide of the court, going for Fromm, like he should have been doing in the end of the last set. He's missed the court. Bucks Poller off to the line. Rijkaard and Fromm just discussing who's supposed to be where, and Fromm, I think, going to go out to that opposite spiker zone. Yes, he is. And I think this is a lineup that works for Germany. Great block. Well, after a set with zero blocks, Ramos and Lima have just pulled one off themselves. And Ramos is a bit of an unusual selection, not a regular middle. Two opposites then, next to each other in the front court, make the block for Argentina. And Ramos with the serve. Right, this is Messi from Germany. Oh, that can be fall as well. Cesare just checking that Zimmermann is okay. Now watch this, he's tumbling backwards, plays the ball, just trips over and disappears. He's all right though, good refereeing. Free net. They'll have to fall over more often. It's a great set to Rijkaard. Argentina convinced this is going to Fromm. And to Brehm from Kreer's point of view. Forgot about Rijkaard. It's always the same. You get your ball in to the setter on a good rhythm like that. Lovely pass from Poglainov, a really heavy serve. You've got the world's best setters running the show. It's the receiving team that has the advantage. Quite unusual in sport. It's not only the server that you feel has got some kind of advantage, but not in volleyball. Where it can tip a little more in favour of the serving team when you've got a server like Fromm who can hit some really heavy topspin. No, that wasn't, that was off pace. Nice pass again from Poglain. Again goes to the middle to Dzeko. Argentina lose the point. Just not getting established in the air at the moment on his offense. Dzeko just struggling to find his middle man. Now does Fromm go big having gone off pace last serve. Goes big, just about passed by Palacios, out of system kill, no, good dig from Zenger. But it's a free ball, Argentina. Oh dear me. Well, Argentina got away with it in the first set. It's quite a lot of individual performances out there on court that was good enough to get them through it. But what's happened now, Germany have clicked into gear. They've found a rotation, system of players that is working. Makes you go giddy, doesn't it? When they hit the camera like that. But this system looks good for Germany. This looks like a really balanced group of players. It's reduced the pressure on Christian Fromm in service reception. 100-fold, I mean, it really has taken him out of that zone. And now he can concentrate on what he does best. Clubbing the ball. That nice fast attack out wide to Palacios. Still not in system. Still on the edge of everything. Look how far Dzeko has to run away from the net to make the set. Super spike on Palacios at 102.5 kilometers per hour. That's his regular hitting speed, really, when he's maneuvering the ball past the block. Probably puts a few clicks on it from the service line. Coming back, it is. Oh, wow. Well, that was audacious. Facundo Conte has been substituted onto the court ahead of Poglain, who looks to me to have run out of steam a little bit. But the new man on court, Conte, rested at the start of this game. Couldn't quite tip it past the block. That is an incredible set from Palacios. Cagey phase of each set. Right at the start, teams feeling each other out a little bit on the rotations. Really good swing from Schott. Gives it the full treatment on this one. Bruno once again getting to discuss middle blocking tactics with one of the best middle blockers that has ever played the game. What a privilege for the German middle unit. Game's just lost some of its fizz here. Germany will be more than happy with that. Argentina fired up for the rest of this match. Decent block again from Lima and Ramos, but knew where the ball was going off a good service. That isolates the hitter. I wouldn't be surprised if we see another swinging momentum back in favour of Argentina. Still feels like it might be one of those games that just seesaws back and forth into a deciding set. See where the ref says this went. If he thinks it's Germany's point, Argentina will have to challenge. And they do. So, point given to Germany for a tip out of court, no touch on the block. Argentina will ask Hawkeye if there was a touch on the block. Here we go. Did this take a piece of anything? Is that the little finger? Well, that little finger looks like it's having a wobble there. but it's been called as a no touch. I think they're going to look at this again to make absolutely sure. Well, in real time, impossible to see. Lima instantly convinced. And that is the reaction of Lima and Marcelo Mendes to seeing the Hawkeye video in the stadium. But the point stays with Germany. Well, how good has Schott been this week? He is an impressive player. Ruben Schott just keeps it all together. 24 years of age, and stands 193 tall, but a couple of seasons with Trefl Gdańsk in the top league of the Polish volleyball has just given him a few tricks. He knows his way past the block. So his side-out game, his side-out hitting, never really seems to be under pressure. And again, that allows him to really concentrate on the things he does well. He's a brilliant service receiver. He's a really excellent defender. I mean, his commitment with two pickups so far, including the bit of footwork by the advertising hoardings earlier in set two, really impressive. And he's got a hell of a serve as well. Very impressed with Ruben Schott. Goes off pace. Easy read for Danani. Germany trying to freeze Danani out of the game at the moment. He's come into this international setup relatively late, the libero in the different coloured shirt for Argentina. But when he has managed to get his arms on the ball to pass, it's been right under Checo's head. It's the successful super spike side out. Atul. New man on court, Facundo Conte, Argentina's talisman for the last decade. Just gets it over. And Christian from his one attack on the left side in this new rotation, puts it away again. He's not missed much, has he? Out at four. Good hustle from Germany again. Very nice set from Zenger. Cheeky tip. Palacios' touch here just takes that out of the way of Danani's dive. Max Polo to serve, tallest man on court for Germany at the moment at 2'10". It's just brilliant. All you can do is smile. When De Checo does things like this, you can only smile. One-handed, reverse set on the money, and Zimmermann takes another one to the chest. A few times yesterday by the USA. Goes on the reverse. Good blocking from Palacios. And again, Germany can go again. From still on the left side of court here. But he can't force it through. And Lima does the rest. See what I mean about Lima and being a clean hitter. Everything in control. Ramos to serve. Still no Sole on court for Argentina. Might see an appearance from the veteran middleman. I say veteran, but one of the older players in the Argentinian team. Bremer's been a bit quiet last two sets, but has nicked the ball off the wing spiker there. Fortunately for him, he put it away. Bremer goes to 6 points. Racket will serve for Germany. Long. Germany not going to challenge. That's why. It's half a metre out. Shooting. Very impressive again from Anton Bremer. And Zimmermann's decided he's the go-to man at the moment. Even when they're dragged across and away from position three, Zimmermann still sets Bremer the B quick, so he sets the ball a couple of metres away from him to the middleman. Makes it a bit cramped, but it also overloads the block that side. From. Heavy serve again, passed by Palacios, but he's the only option. And a wonderful hustle from Rijkaard. Little side tandem from Argentina. I love it when teams can still run a combination play as slick as that under pressure on transition. Lovely pickup from Rijkaard. And then watch this. Little pop ball over the top of the middle player. That was so discreetly disguised that Pablo Creer thought it was for him. He had a swing at that. Once again, wonderful disguise from the captain and setter, De Checo, for Argentina. Good heavy blow from the back line. Christian Fromm doing a really good job for his team at the moment. That's the point. Your go-to man has to be the man you want to go to. Christian Fromm making sure that he is available for Zimmermann and putting the ball away for his team. Still really haven't hit a golden zone yet, have we, in this match? It's all been a little bit piecemeal. Great play, serve out. Another great play, serve out. It's been that kind of game. Creer. Easy pass. Easy kill for Bugs Poller. Tame. Issues for both teams here. Rather tame midsection of the third set. Checo gets one in. It's in play. Danani nicks it off his captain. Dante can't put it away. But not a problem for Rijkaard, and that's off a three-man block as well. Beats the triple with ease. Defence in there, but both teams having chances to put it away. It's Germany through Rijkaard that do it. He's a happy man, is Andrea Gianni. Things have changed in this match. Changing once again in favour. Marcelo Mendes says that's out. We're going to challenge that immediately. Had a quick look round. He was convinced it was out, but had a quick look round at the substitutes to say, did you see it? Overcuts it, but that might just have clipped the outside of the line. Rijkaard convinced. So Argentinian challenge. Is it in or out? And there you go. Pretty obviously in. Good hit from Rijkaard. Gianni continues to be happy. Now, Germany get themselves into the technical timeout with the lead at 16-14. It's on shot serve, so they've got a chance. Been pretty consistent so far from the service line. That is unbelievable. What a hit from Palacios. That is so fast. Look at this ball. It is only just over the middle player. I mean, that is a B quick being hit by the wing spiker from the back line in the front court. This ball continues to move to new dimensions. But the old physics still apply. ball through the net, and if it doesn't go over, you lose the point. 16-15, Germany have the lead. It's going to be another tight finish.
Stiamo entrando nella seconda parte, quella più importante del set. Zweite wichtige Hälfte des Satzes. La battuta, i nostri flop, Jan, Max, la battuta, Kubi, la battuta. E la palla alta, l'attacco della palla alta.
L'Ausagabe non hanno holen bei den, Lösungen.
Wie sie gesagt haben. Trovare nell'ultimo passo, entrare
dentro,
Christian Fromm played plenty of volleyball in Italy, speaks Italian, and an interesting change up there from Gianni. I think he wanted to talk through his captain because he knew his captain would be more animated and vociferous. Lovely shot of Pablo Creer, right on top of the net. He's doing a good job at the moment for Argentina. Pablo Creer, been a regular side-out option for the Checo, even under pressure. Can bring some blocks to the net when he comes back on the court in the front zone. At the moment, on the bench for the libero, Danani. Bakspola restarts then. Oh, that's a good eye from Danani. Referee says it's out. Danani is comfortable that it is. So, challenge from Germany. The question that they are asking Hawkeye is, was it in or was it out? Argentina convinced this was out. Hawkeye agrees with them. We're almost getting to the stage where a substitute should be assigned to baseline duty. So keep an eye on those shots and be confident about challenges. 16 all. Germany to attack, should be able to take the advantage back. They do. Nice set again from Zimmermann. Let's not forget the role that Zimmermann plays within this German team. As flamboyant as his opposite number on the other side of the net, Checo. Boy, is he solid, and he gets enough free nets as well for his hitters to make them happy. Rijkaard with the kill, and Rijkaard with the serve. Yeah, good heavy hit, and we're back to a nice trading set here. Both teams just trading points. All done on the side out. So every time your opponent serves, you kill the ball. Just turn the scoreboard over. Lima then, looking to make a difference. Heavy hit from Fromm, goes off the hands of the Argentinian block. Germany sided out, out of system as well. Fromm has done his job today. Struggled on service reception, but they've sorted that out now. They've got Rijkaard shot on court, so they can hide the captain on serve receive. Nowhere to hide, though, from the Fromm serve if he gets it right. Oh, yes. Big ace. And Christian Fromm gets the lawnmower started. He has humped that one. Well, Facundo Conte thought it was his, but it's bent away from him at 107.1 kilometers per hour. That's pushing it in terms of reaction time, and it's taken Conte off court. So Krom has served Facundo Conte back to the bench. Back out comes Poglayan. He's looking a little tired in the last set. That's why he vacated the court. Heavy hit again. Well controlled by Palacios. And beautiful dig from Zenga. Germany can win the point. They can still win the point. And shot does it. Off the hands and out. A hilarious pickup from Fromm in the middle of that rally. Ran in and just poking it up into the air. Look at that. right on Zimmerman's head. Astonishing stuff. And another very clever, tidy kill. Shot. Good stuff. Pretty close to a carry in the middle of that rally. I think that's what Argentina are unhappy about. Rijkaard's play.
Para atacar el bloqueo, ¿sí? Juegan los puntas nada más. Saquémosle a los puntas, tratemos de evitar el ataque de los puntas directamente. Porque están jugando con punta nada más.
Time out Argentina, and Marcelo Mendes knows his team are now in trouble. It's official. 3-point cushion for Germany. Should be enough to see them through to a 2-1 lead. We can't see Gianni changing things up too much because this rotation out on court has worked really well. Bizarrely, he's left from in the wing spiker position, but he's flipping with Rijkaard. So Rijkaard's going left side, Fromm's going right, and it's kind of working. Here we go again. Off pace, easy pass. And easy kill by Lima. Hits the ball, very controlled. So stable in the air. So Ezequiel Palacios with the serve to try and close the gap here. Argentina need to win 2 points on their serve at some point before Germany gets to 25. They're not going to be doing that with Fromm in this kind of form. That was a ripper. Super spike then from the German captain. But he's done it past one blocker. It's another lovely set from Zimmerman. Well, I really am amazed that this substitution has happened again. So Hirsch has been bought on, damaged ankle and all. Got a big ankle brace on that ankle that he twisted on day one. And he's been asked to come on and hit another jump serve. He missed the last one. It's in, but it's easy. Well, Hirsch would normally run the play there, and he didn't even move. Missed opportunity for Germany. Really should have killed this ball. But taking his hands away very cleverly, the replacement opposite Pereira. So Argentina have made their double substitution and flipped the rotation. So Uriarte in the number 5 shirt is on, the new setter for De Checo. So the captains have been called over because Marcelo Mendes and Andrea Gardini have been having a few words, coaches exchanging some interesting and differing opinions down there on the floor. Refs asked them to calm it down. Regular as clockwork, isn't he? Shot. It's double figures for Germany at the moment, and incidentally, their top scorer after a tricky start to the match is their captain, Christian Fromm, now on 15 points, shot on 11. And then Rijkaard, Bremer, Bakspola, all on 7 apiece. Lima and Palacios, top scorers for Argentina, 14 and 13 respectively. Well, Argentina celebrating, but they've not got much to celebrate because they're struggling in this set. Uriarte to Poglan. Is Uriarte going to stay on with Pereira? Or are they going to flip the substitution again? They do. De Checo comes on for Pereira. Back on comes Lima for Uriarte. And once again, three rotations with three strong hitters and blockers in the front court for Argentina. It's a good tactic. It's a really good substitution tactic, and it works. That's brilliant. absolutely brilliant from Palacios. Great defence. Reuse, though, for Germany. And a huge hit from Rijkaard. Real swipe at the ball there from the number five. Under control. It's a terrific dig from Palacios on the original attack from Fromm. 5 kilometers per hour. He's fast. Free serve routine for shot, all familiar now. Good serve, overpass. Not put away. Oh, it is now. Spoiler didn't really hit that one hard. We're going to have a challenge here because as far as Marcelo Mendes is concerned and his assistant coach, he's touched the net. What he's forgotten is there are no challenges remaining. Now, I think that should be a time delay yellow card if you ask for something that you don't have. If you were to ask for a timeout and you've got none left, you'd be carded. He does have a timeout, so that's what he's called. It's a bit of a head-scratching moment. I knew today was going to be a tricky one for Argentina after the glories of yesterday's victory against France.
Los puntos nos están haciendo todos los puntos, señores. Saquemos los puntos. Saquemos fuerte, ¿sí? Si tenemos que darle dirección, démosle los puntos. El jugador de 5 defienda acá atrás directamente. 5 y 6 defiendan acá atrás porque ninguna bola salió por la diagonal en
it's
ataque.
It's a footfall. Vamos. Oh, dear me. Well, they were actually talking about a challenge for the net touch. But if they challenged on the footfall, they'd have won the point. Germany get away with one. You know what's going to happen now, don't you? Shot's going to ace them for the set. That's in the script. Can he do it? Off pace. No, controlled. And that's a really strong put away by Lima. But Argentina still in a tricky position here. They've got to win 3 points on their own serve to take this set into overtime. And then it all comes down to who your server is. Well, it's okay. It's Poglayan. He can hit them. And Argentina can win this point. They win it very comfortably through Palacios. One set point saved with a super spike from Palacios. 112.9 kilometers per hour. He's cranking it today. Is the number 13 for Argentina. Now it's Andrea Gianni's turn to call a timeout. Sensible coaching from the Italian.
Don't fly,
all right?
And,
guys, focus
on the side out,
eh?
Very simple. He wanted to make one point to Bucks Poller. Don't fly, he said. What he means is he doesn't want his middle blocker drifting away from the diagonal that he's trying to block. Now we've got a cracking match to follow this one. And France are in the house. France-USA, our second game of the day. In the close to this one, and they might be there for a while because this could run. Poglayan, good serve again. Germany trying to win this set. It's going to be tight. Oh, it's still in play. Brilliant by Argentina. Now, can Germany get the job done here? Rijkaard can't kill it. The Nani goes to Lima, and Lima gets it off the block. And a mega rally with some stunning pinball defence from Argentina. Means we get a continuation. There's a nice pancake from shot to keep things going. And then look at this. Rattles around the Argentinian players and back into play before finally Lima whacks it off the German captain's arms. And just like set two, we're down to a single point game. Gianni goes back to Italian for that little bit of impetus and vocality from his captain on the translation. Argentina, though, have to go back to the service line after the timeout. This is a huge mental demand for Pugliese. USA are in as well. They've arrived. Two wins from two for the USA. France losing yesterday. Will it be a bounce back victory for them after their loss to Argentina? Argentina then trying to stay in this set. No. And a good timeout from Andrea Gianni does enough to disturb the concentration of Pugliese at the service line. And it happens so often. Pressure was on the number six for Argentina. And he just couldn't respond. 25-23 then, Germany looking good for the win at the moment. Two sets by the same scoreline to recover from the rather sticky start with a rotation that just didn't really work. But the changes that Andrea Gianni have made to this German lineup have worked. Germany lead 2-1. Shaky at the end of both the sets that they've won, Germany, but they've had enough points in the bank to get it done. And Germany continue to impress. The Argentinian serve just not quite putting what has been a really good service reception unit under pressure. And I think Schott, Reichert, and in particular Zenger, probably leading the service reception stats right now for the VNL. They've been incredibly impressive. And that has partly helped Zimmermann run a really decent offense to keep Germany in decent shape in this match. Desperate not to have five match losses on the bounce. So still in the balance for Defner. Germany certainly going into set four now. Marginal favourites, and I think Argentina have to make some changes. Don't see Gianni changing anything. This slightly weird and wonderful lineup is working. New shirt for the skipper.
Merci François, merci
Hervé. He helped to prize himself into that. Very much the modern way, isn't it, the figure-hugging shirts. I do remember a few German players when it became the vogue for these quite tight playing shirts. A few of the old German league players saying, well, that's the end of my career then. Now, the changes I spoke about for Argentina are being made. It's a big call to bring players on from the bench this late in the match, but when they're as talented as the middle blocker, Argentina, Sebastian Sulli in the number 11 shirt, might just be able to make a difference here. So off goes Loza. On comes Sulli in the middle. Still out there, Pablo Correa, Argentina's tallest player. Pacheco just checking the rotation. That's the last thing Argentina need, for the rotation to be wrong. And it does happen sometimes. Coaches do write the wrong series of numbers down. Catastrophic, but we're fine here. Lima holds his place in the opposite position. Dzeko will start at setter for Germany. No changes. Bugs Pola to serve. Set four underway. Argentina survive to take the point. A really good hitter, Lima. Puts another one away very comfortably. Knew where the space was. Bruno Lima, the 23-year-old, finding it. That's a good service reception unit, Germany. There you go, right on the setter's head. Just out. Another ferocious hit from Lima. What he seems very good at doing is seeing when he's got one block to beat, and when it's just the single blocker, he hits it really hard. Just trust there that he can go on the diagonal pass from, and does so with ease. Good start for Argentina. Really good shot from that end on camera to show how the setter works that deception with the pipe attack. Because essentially you've got two players running into the same zone on the net, which you'd have thought would be better for the middle blocker to process. But when you've got them running at different times and in slightly different places, it's a really tricky thing for the middles to work out. So back to this rather sketchy opening part of the set. Teams don't always get going here. They know that this really is just the calm before the storm, as it were. The warm-up to the big part of the set. Kochian, the backup setter, and the lay-down. And a good block from Soleil. Makes an immediate impact then from the bench. Certainly was a star in yesterday's performance against France, and not many blockers have stopped Anton Bremer this week. Soleil joins Chinonyesi as one of them that has. Well, it's very early in this fourth set, but there's a whiff of a five-setter in the air. Günther watches on as Germany decide to challenge here. No, it's a timeout, it's not a challenge, sorry. And it would have been an unsuccessful challenge anyway, from touching the net comfortably and Andrea Gianni having to stop because he knows his players are losing their way rapidly. In set four. That one fell apart. Argentinian players having a bit of a shout at each other in the middle of that rally. Marcios in the end just wailing it into the net tape. Potential route back in, early doors for Germany with the from serve. A couple of quick aces here would do them the world of good. Off pace, well passed by Danani. It's a nice touch from Zimmermann in the block, but a poor pass from Germany allows Argentina to attack again. Great shot from overhead. And then just an appreciation from that spike contact point. 320s up there, 330s off the top of the antenna. From Sossenheimer joins in the applause for his captain. Yeah. hits it than Lee. And then has to just limbo away from the net. Successfully so. Good shot of Bremer's serve. Can't defend it though, Rijkaard. So Argentina finding their way back into this match, getting a bit of rhythm here. Germany just have to keep pace with Argentina. Don't let them get too far away. Already in a fairly precarious position in this set. What Argentina did to France yesterday in set four and just stayed with them for long enough and then powered away for the win. Zimmermann to serve. Good rotations for Germany at the net. Out and wide. Lima not even vaguely suggesting a challenge here. So he must have known he was a long way from the block. And then the net take. Net under quite a lot of tension to keep it all in place. So if you hit the net take, the ball does ricochet off quite a distance. Buxpol have got a really good hand on that one. Crea gets the kill, but only just. For once, Buxpol committing in the middle, nearly worked.
Last set out, good rhythm and sequence. The exclamative ball, we can touch the ball, eh? Yeah. We can touch. Especially when we have in front, touch.
Go, 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 go.
Well, I've mentioned shot, but the other part of the wing spiking duo for Germany is this young man. Number five shirt. Doing a really good job for his team. Is Moritz Rijkaard, also 24 years of age, the same shot, scored well yesterday in their game against the USA. Plays for Berlin Recycling Volleys. Several pro clubs in Berlin. Again, it's the two parts of his game that impress. The fact that as good as he is as a swing hitter, he's a fantastic passer. I think Germany have got a couple of really good wing spikers in this squad. Controlled this time, though, by the libero, Zenger. Oh, no. And just as we feature Rijkaard, he does the little tippy-toe dance along the line and overbalances. So he whacks it, wasn't the best of sets to hit, lands, and then just can't stop himself stepping over the line. Argentina retain comfortable control in set four. It's a good hit, and it's out. Ruben shot. Nice serve. Really good serve. And to beat Danani, that means you've hit a belter. The libero for Argentina's had a really good week. Too fast for him there. And Solé knows a couple of those, and Germany will be back in business in set four. A serve. Or Ruben Schott. Takes him to 12 points. Good contribution from the wing spiker. Goes back to the float this time. Well, I'm not sure about the change up there. Not quite sure why he decided not to hit a second jump serve after the first one was so good. Too easy to pass. Too easy for Argentina to kill it. Oh, keeper. 1 point clawed back, so Argentina lead by 3. Yeah, good work. Nicely defended by Poglayan, though. Oh, that's horrible. Well, rule of thumb, no offence to the middle blockers, is don't let the middle blockers volley it. Bless them. Pablo Carrer trying to hide. Now, what's the challenge for here? Oh, it's a good challenge as well. It's Schott now who stepped over the centre line. And that's what the referees are going to have a look at here. Now, did the whole foot go over? If it's shadowing the line, Schott will get away with this. But as he landed from that pipe attack, he definitely put his toe to the other side. But the whole foot's got to be over here. And it is. It is. Brilliant spot. That's Marcelo Mendes that saw that, the Argentinian coach. Very, very well spotted. Pablo Carrer's little error on the set can be ignored. Argentina go back to a 4-point margin. This time he can run onto the other side of the net because the ball's dead. Super spike from Schott. Yeah, lovely stuff. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Goodness me. Everything working. All flowing right through the ball. And the maximum power gets you maximum speed. 120 kilometers per hour on the speed gun. It's a thunderbolt from Schott, but a response immediately from Argentina, who've got this set by the scruff of the neck, looking to take it to a tiebreaker. Chance to score. Danani goes on the reverse to Palacios. Germany are going to get this back. But Argentina go again. Lima. Down it goes. I think we're going to 5. And I think everybody here in the Palais de Victoire knows it, including Germany. Fair amount of time to play out in set 4. Still the opportunity for Germany to serve themselves back in to this game, but it's going to be a big ask. From boarding off his wing to have to try and hit the ball out of system. Argentina creating the opportunity with the defence. But as soon as you come in off your wing, the dimensions change. You've not got as much court to aim at. One would have been aware of that, but he probably wasn't aware how far he was across. I mean, he was nearly in the middle position. No touch, ball out, more points to Argentina's cause. Another great serve, well passed by Zenger. He's hitting it really well, isn't he, Schott? A super spike for Ruben. And the end line judge having to take evasive action on that occasion. 116.5 kilometers per hour, it's a slower one. He's fizzing it. Oh, nicely done. No fuss, no nonsense from Argentina. They've got their noses in front now. It's just about ticking the scoreboard over. Solé gets the set from Dzeko. A little bit low, but contorts himself quite nicely there to hit it. 15-9. Would you believe it? Some of the substitutes there for Argentina don't look too happy that it's going to five. A serve. Surely a challenge from Germany. Yeah. Zenger says out. Challenge. Andrea Gardini. Gianni happy to respond. So Hawkeye, was it in or out? Gianni looks pretty relaxed about it all. Here we go. Are we going to the technical or are we going to play on? Ooh, marginal. Good eye from Zenger. It's the libero for Germany that called that one. Now, this is a chance for a few points here for Germany. Argentina's head will be in the technical timeout now, thinking they got there with an ace, and Sossenheimer with a chance to make a name for himself. Can he get two or three points on his service run? Not with a serve like that. I'm not kidding you, but Sossenheimer might have well as underarmed that one. Poor serve. And while Germany defended the first one, it came back with interest off the next one. Another free net from De Checo to Palacios. 16-10. Technical timeout arrives.
Sí. No tienen ataque por uno. Se fue front, no tienen ataque por uno ninguna. Vamos de la mitad para adelante siempre. Están buscando con alternativa cuando recibe el libre de jugar la pay. Cuando recibe el libre están tratando de jugar.
It's been good again as the number 12 in the opposite position, the 23-year-old, hit 18 points. Super game against France. Stands 1.98 meters, touches the ball at 3.45 on his attack. Plays for the TV Bouy Volleyball Club. And right at the start of his international career, these are the first caps that he's picked up at this level against teams like this. Came on day one, just in the double substitution for Pereira, the normal starting player. Thought then that he looked like a pretty decent prospect. And he's delivering 21 points for Argentina at the moment. He's got hot just when they need him to. And they need him now to stay hot for another set and a half. Bremer stopped. Not as effective in this game, Bremer through the middle for Germany. But shot is their man at the moment. Putting the ball away nicely. Not a great set from De Checo. Very important for the backcourt hits that you keep the ball in front of the 3 meter line. If you put it behind, it's going to be slowing the player down with their approach, but that one is too close to the net. Pretty easy for Bugs Poehler to get a big paw on it. Got hands like dinner plates, says Bugs Poehler. Oh, that's a footfall. Courtesy of our overhead camera as well. Easy to see that one. Bremer. So brief chance of a comeback gone. There we go. That baseline is completely out of bounds to the server. Can't step on it or over it. Nice calm kill from Sossenheimer. Germany take the ball back. There have been discussions because the jump serve is getting so influential in the game. There have been discussions that the servers must now jump from behind the baseline, hit the ball and land behind the baseline still, but that hasn't come in as a rule of yet, so servers can still hit and jump right into court. Hey! able to mount a serious comeback challenge at the moment. Sending the latest service error. Bog Lyon's been serving well, so could do some damage here. And does. Ace. And Zenger going straight over to the passer to say that was out. I called it out and you still played it. And he's absolutely right. Rijkaard has barely done a thing wrong. Didn't see Zimmermann coming there, did he? Andrea Gardini nearly got a face full of setter. Chance here. Oh, that's really good. That is really good. Totally and utterly out of system. So the first ball is almost never played by the setter, but Dzeko plays it and just turned it into a second ball and set it straight up for a fast-arriving Bog Lyon, who simply repeats his service tactic and technique and hammers it away. Argentina all over set four. So a little bit of work with the muscle massager on the calves for one of the French team. That's Le Goff. Just getting his muscles massaged out ahead of this one. It's been a long couple of days. I love that. That's a great look, isn't it, from Ngapet to the big middleman. Look of disdain. What are you doing? Good try from Bog Lyon. So a controlled jump serve, trying to hit this as accurately as he could onto the line. He just worked it out too far. Decent effort, but the damage has been done. Two good points from him on the service. Takes Argentina away to a six-point cushion. It's not coming back, it's hit the antenna. Despite Dzeko's best efforts. And a really good serve again from Schott. He's the player today for Germany. Three serve aces, 17 points, 13 attacks, one block. One block was a good one though. It was on the hit of Dzeko. Read it well. Good. Heavy hit again, beautiful pass from Denani. And Germany can score another point. Sossenheimer, though, given the ball right underneath the block. Hospital set, I'm afraid. Not much you can do with this. Look how far the block can reach over. They just basically grab hold of the ball just after he touches it. It was never going anywhere except down. Lima getting one wrong. He's been really good in this game up until now. 22 points to his name. 16 successful attacks, 5 blocks and a serve. Nice, but this time just doesn't quite make it work. Germany, I'm sure, are going to lose this set. But there's a bit of momentum coming back to them here. Now, we're going to have a challenge. So, sure, this is going to be for a block touch. Marcelo Mendes is just going to ask the question, did it hit the hands of the German block? Germany just feeling, I'm sure, here that Argentina not quite as fluid as they were at the start of this set, which bodes well for a fifth set decider. Here we go. We're going to see a little finger movement on the German block. We are not, by the looks of it. No touch. Mighty close to the fingernails of Rijker. But not a touch. Germany have another point here. So Backspoiler with the serve. Brings Bremer back to the front line for Germany. There he is, the youngster. Waiting patiently. Hands on the back of the head in case the server hits them in the back of the head. Tight. No, that's going to be Germany's. Solé, rather unusually for such an experienced middle blocker, interfering with the set, which you're not allowed to do. Yeah, just put the fingers on it and took it away from Bremer. That is the German side of the net as well, so great call from Stefano Cesari, the referee. Timeout Argentina, they're suffering a bit at the moment.
Tener una opción de ataque, no la pasemos directamente del otro lado. Subámonos firme para atacar, señores.
6-point lead becomes 3. Via a challenge and a couple of dodgy plays from Argentina. Backspoiler's serve, not a tough one to pass, so there's no real pressure from the service line at the moment from Germany. See the passing unit slanted across the court, all facing the server. No, another point coming for Germany. Well, it does, just. And the only way that Ruben Schott stopped himself going over the line here was to collapse to his knees and stop his forward momentum short of the line. It's a clever bit of thinking from the wing spiker off a poor set from Zimmermann. I say poor set, it's a set under pressure. That was a tense set. Saying I'm just explaining the technique for stopping yourself going over the centre line at full tilt. Well, I'll take it back about Backspoiler's serving. He's just shoved one up really high in Palacios' chest. And he's tried to overhand pass it. No, it's Mendes, new on court. He's completely messed that up. Kochian's happy.
En la primera, metámosle bien los dedos a la bola, subámosla para poder centralizarla.
I'll read the body language. Last time out for Argentina, and it was of the what the hell are you doing variety. What a comeback from Germany. This match should have been going to 5 sets. Germany have a chance of getting it done in 4. Argentina only have themselves to blame. They've got to sort this out. So timeout called, but Backspoiler's serve is not a high-risk one. It's a good serve on Mendes again. Lima forces it past the block and out. Sossenheimer still on the front court, replacing Rijker at the moment. Oh no, it's replacing Fromm, my apologies. Rijker still out there, but good leave from the German block. Didn't chase the ball. A 6-point comeback from Germany in set 4. Brilliant. Well played to them. But can they continue it from here? Mendes off court. On comes Poglayan for Argentina. So the original wing spiker back on. Argentina scrubbing around for points. They can't put this ball away. Chances. Oh, that's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Zimmermann just had a little look out wide to Sossenheimer, and that was enough for Sossenheimer to realise this set was going to be fast, and it was very fast. Block couldn't form, line open, and Germany take the lead. 7 consecutive points. Baxpola has worked a number on Argentina from the service line here. Conte in, Palacios out. Desperation from Argentina. And a nice kill finally from Lima, but the damage has been done. We're back to a level game here. Bruno Lima with the kill. Takes him to a fabulous 23 points for the match. But doesn't matter how many you score, if you're on the losing side, it's never great. Now, Rijkaard was set tight again by Zimmermann. The decision has gone Argentina's way. And I think Germany fancy a challenge here. Who touched the net? Well, no, it's gone into the antenna. Yeah, that will be Argentina's point regardless. So no challenge forthcoming. Easy pass. Sossenheimer blocked, and Argentina back in business. And after suffering a horrible run of points against them, a monster block from Dzeko and Solé puts the ball down for two set points, and Germany now, after a brilliant comeback, staring at a fifth set decider. Lima going for the ace, going for broke. And Germany handed a lifeline here. Well, he wants a challenge, but his coach says no. Rijkaard to serve, still one set point for Argentina. Good pass from Dinani. And Germany get it up, shot off pace. Argentina go again. And they still can't get this ball away from. He gets blocked. Surely now Argentina, Lima. And a mega rally developing here. No, Fromm's missed it. Would you believe it? Well, terrific stuff from Germany to give themselves a chance. But in the end, Argentina hang in there in the rally. And a mega rally to finish the set. Couple of really nice plays to continue this. But in the end, a bit of a shame. Captain Fromm misses the court, misses the block. And Germany find themselves at two sets all with Argentina. Last three sets have been close, all 25-23. But this one in favour of the South American team. That means only one thing. We are going to a tiebreaker set to 15 points to sort it out between these two. Play on. We nearly didn't. Argentina, the architects of their own downfall at one point, but just getting back in time to get that across the line for Germany. Took a real nosedive at the start of that set, but recovered well. And a 7-point run on Baxpola's serve, nearly good enough, but not in the end. So two sets apiece. Tiebreaker set required. Remember, the tiebreaker set runs to 15 points. Play on to two clear with no ceiling if required. At the moment, there is not much between these two teams. So let's take a look at Argentina's spike placement during the course of this match. Lima the best of them, just ahead of Palacios. And they are pretty much picking their shots all over the court because Dzeko is giving them so many one-on-one blocks. But a lot of those sets going through the middle zone and through the right side, and that's why Lima has scored so many points at the moment. So 17 spikes, but 23 points overall. Great contribution from him. Back to the business in hand. France and USA next onto the main court. They're in the stadium watching. But they can't start their warm-up until this one is over. And we are still none the wiser. Germany trying to avoid five losses on the trot in the VNL. Argentina going for their fourth win and trying to make it back-to-back wins after yesterday's fabulous 3-1 defeat of France. So then, service with Germany, fifth set, away we go. Lovely start. And it's that man, Lima, again, hitting a really sharp angle. But watch Bucks Poehler, he doesn't drop his arm on the diagonal, he reaches to the ball. He tried, but he was just drifting. Good kill from Lima, he's at the line. Serve, good pass from Zenger. A miss from Rijkaard, but he says it's touched the blocker. It's definitely out. Now, the challenge is for the block touch. I'm wondering whether Stefano Cesari has asked to see this one himself. I will tell us, did this ping a finger? It did. Oh, dear me, look at the movement of Solé's finger. Oh, dear, that's all over the place. Well spotted by the German attackers, well challenged. And here's the serve that did all the damage in the last set, nearly got Germany back into it. Bucks Poehler. They could do with another seven here from him. Brilliant from Dzeko. That's awesome. Jumped as if he was going to spike the ball, and as soon as he saw the blockers go with him, just sets it on the reverse for another free net. That's a training session hit for Lima. 3:20 the contact point. Had to be Argentina's point. Great setting from the captain. Palacios to serve. 2-1 Argentina. All the momentum at the moment with the team in white. Germany hanging in there. But it's a fight at the moment for Germany. And Argentina getting off to by far the better start. Off the arms of Christian Fromm and out. Andrea Gianni has to stop it pretty quickly with a timeout before more damage is done.
Cosa facciamo con le aperture sull'opposto? Cosa gli muriamo? Diagonale. Io non voglio vedere posto 4 che sulle aperture è qua.
Well, an Italian timeout, no translation from Fromm. Just the pictures doing the job on the clipboard. As the timeout had the desired effect. Palacios needs to compose himself, set himself again. And it does have the desired effect. That's the second time Andrea Gianni has called a timeout in this match and got a service error off the back of it. Still nothing in it, but Germany just chasing this a little. Argentina look more composed. Nice out of system kill from Poglayan. Lovely set from Dzeko, way off the net. Work in the hands of Fromm. That's why the fingers are so heavily taped. Take a bit of stick in the match. A bit messy. Argentina will be disappointed they didn't recycle this one. Decent touch, but Dzeko, as it comes off the net, just trying to bump this back into his team, ends up bumping it away. Fantastic. Stefano Cesari's view of the whole proceedings from the referee's stand. Still, Argentina continue to kill the ball under pressure.
Number six, Christian
Poglayan. Poglayan's serve. It's been tricky for Germany. Again, Zimmermann forced off the net. Finally, out of system, they don't kill one. Here we go, this weird and wonderful substitution. So Hirsch is on to try and lash a jump serve. After he's hit his jump serve, the ankle is still bad. So his mobility is virtually zero. Don't think we'll try and see him run a pipe. Don't think we'll see him chase too much down. This is just about throwing the ball up in front of him and hitting it hard. Third time the substitution's been made, second time it's gone wrong. Hirsch, not surprisingly, immediately vacates the court for Bremer. Bremer immediately vacates the court for Zenger, the libero. All a bit busy down there on the sideline for Germany. Well, Argentina initially thought that had gone down on the German side, but this has been shoved straight down the front of Pablo Correa's block. From hitting that ball so hard, it actually drove the Argentinian's middleman's arms back, created the space. Germany hanging on. Yeah, lovely extension from Dzeko. Jumps, stretches to full extension, and just sets it beautifully on the reverse. Easy ball for Lima to latch onto and hit hard. Whoa. Christian Fromm on the pipe attack. Reduces the lead to one again. Real commitment on that. He's hit it very hard. Soler just couldn't decide what line he was going to go on. In the end, guessed the wrong line. Shot's been good today with his serving. On that occasion, though, easy side out for Argentina. Takes them to 8-6. And at 8 points, we have a change of ends so that there's no advantage within the arena. Lima at the service line, so it doesn't get any better for Germany. One mini break for Argentina means Germany have to side out and then win a point on their own serve to get level. So Lima would dearly love to earn another point for Argentina off his own serve, and he's not going to with that. Massive miss hit. Already our longest game here in Cannes this week. Just over the 2.5 hour mark now. Good hit. The mini break still stays. So every time Argentina side it out, they go back to a 2-point margin. And that will be good enough to win them this match, unless Germany can win a serve or win a point on their own serve. Palacios at the line. Zimmermann is near side of court, the German setter, so he's got to run across to position two. It's a tricky rotation, this. And a brilliant serve from Palacios. And Christian Fromm cannot bring that back into play, despite valiant efforts from the German captain. Ace serve. 3-point margin opened up. Argentina in control here. Good coaching there from Andrea Gianni. Knew that the sweat was being cleared up from the dive of his captain from. So just waited and waited for the all that to be sorted, then called the timeout.
First pass.
I think we always expect to hear more when we drop in on the timeouts. Some amazing high-powered coaching information, but occasionally it's the basics that matter. Pass the ball, set the ball, hit the ball, says Gianni. USA team waiting around with France as well, also in the stadium. Ahead of their encounter to follow. But we got this one to sort out first. Palacios with the serve. Follows it nicely off the back of the timeout. It's a big shot from Fromm, but contained. And Pereira on court with the double substitution with Uriarte putting it away nicely. Big hit, and Denani's made a super dig there on the German captain, Pereira. Just spinning it into the block and hoping for the best. And Argentina now in the driving seat. Palacios has served well. One ace, one heavy serve. Can he follow it? He can. From this time, though. Finds a way through, super spike from the German captain. He's hit this really hard. No chance for Denani on that occasion. 5.2, not the fastest spike we've seen today, but pretty tasty. Rijkaard to serve. Free net. And this time, it's not Dzeko, it's Uriarte. And here we go, lovely reverse, fill your boots up. There's nobody there. Pereira, more than happy to do so. Germany running out of options, running out of points here. Solé to serve, it's a relatively easy serve. Passing unit ready. Pass. Bremer contained. Uriarte wide. And Poglian puts it away. Argentina flying now. And back-to-back victories here in Cannes to conclude their week three campaign on the VNL, starting to look like a realistic possibility. Good swing from Poglian. Solé again. 13-8. 2 points required for Argentina. Miss hit from From. O'Lion tips it deep, but easily read. Yeah, well worked. Very well worked by Germany. Good hustle in defence, and then once it got to Zimmermann, yes, managing to find the teenager Bremer in the front court. Quiet game today, Bremer. But the previous 2 days, he's been awesome. Now, can the German captain be the hero? Well passed. And well put away. Argentina need one more point to make it back-to-back victories here on the French Riviera. Herrera to serve. They've left Uriarte on court. So there's a shorter blocker out on one of the wings for Germany to aim at if they can pass the serve. They do. Bremer humps it through the middle. That's a big hit from him. Takes him to double figures. Another decent contribution. Made that one that very hard. But 4 match points for Argentina. And they get it done. First time of asking. Overpass. It's going to come back, but it's a free ball. And this is it for Argentina here, surely. It is. And after an absolute battle with Germany here on Sunday in Cannes, Argentina get it across the line. It's 2 victories from 2 to finish their campaign on week 3. And they will be very, very happy with that. And that surely allows them to head into the rest of the VNL season knowing that survival looks like it's going to be realistic. They've played well this weekend. This was always going to be a tough one today. Some tired legs out there on court. Germany really up for it, desperate for the win, knowing that they beat them last time, beat Argentina in last year's encounter. But Argentina get some revenge and leave France a very, very happy team. What a game. 25-19 Argentina in the first set, 25-23, 25-23 Germany hit back, and then by the same scoreline Argentina levelled it after a massive German comeback in set 4. And then in the decider, 15-10, relatively straightforward for the Argentinian team. Didn't do a huge amount at the net, but certainly didn't do anything wrong. Germany just couldn't contain them. So our first 5-setter here in Cannes. That was a real scrap between these two teams for Germany. They're going to have to think about the rest of the weeks on the VNL, understanding that they've got to have wins. Otherwise, their future is going to be dicey. But Andrea Gianni, the kind of coach that can turn it around and get the best out of his players, but he's going to have to. Unlucky for Bremer, he's played well for 3 days and got nothing for it. So let's have a little look at how that reflects on the table. Iran still flying high at the top of the VNL. Russia, Brazil, France and Italy all looking good to go to the finals. It's going to be a real fight though, isn't it? To get into qualification with the USA, who are going to play France. Iran, Russia playing as we speak. And Iran, one set up at the moment. Well, would you expect anything else? They've been brilliant so far this year. At home, they've been unstoppable. Russia with their work cut out. So that's how things stand in the top 8. Argentina, look at that, doing themselves a huge favour with those 2 victories, jumping from 11th to 8th place. Well played to Argentina. So, the victorious selfie, 2 days in a row for the South American team. They've had a good time here in Cannes. they've brought it home with two very nice victories, which will take a lot of pressure off this team. They're a talented squad, but it was only a matter of time before the victories started to come. So that's it for our first game here in Cannes. France, USA will take to the court next, but Argentina get their second win of the weekend. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. Thank you for being part of the game.